This time we're going to talk about users. And what are users in terms of GrandMA3? Users are something you need if you run a multi-console setup. If you have more than one console, more than one programmer, maybe you have two consoles front of house, and maybe you have a console on stage for doing maintenance, you need multiple users not to interfere with each other. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how that works. So let's just get into it. So as you can see over here, I am logged in as myself right now, and that's really cool. I'm logged in as myself on both the console and the onpc. And that works, you can do everything, but basically they mimic each other. So if I do something over here, it's gonna affect the console over here. And I can just show you, if I change my view, you can see the view changes over here as well. And sometimes that is not what you want, because you can't have someone programming on one console and it affects the other one. That means that when he's doing something, he's going to change whatever he's doing over here. So we want to create a user that can sit and work on this station and a user that can work on this station without them affecting each other. So what we do is we go into our settings and our user configuration, and you can see my user here, my user profile. You have a user here, which is basically the login, the shell, and then you have some of the settings in your profile underneath. So what I want to do is I want to create a new user. So we say new user, we just say insert new user. It says user 6, and we can just change the name to new, for instance. And then we go to profiles, and then you can see I have two different profiles. And what is a profile? A profile is basically your screen layout and some of the settings you have, and the way you have stored stuff in your, basically your views and all that stuff. So you don't want these two to affect each other. It's no good when I create a new view on one console, it's automatically doing it over here. So what I can do is I can copy the user profile to the new user, and I can use the copy of the profile on the new user. And that means they are identical when I do the copy, and after that they can start working in each direction. They are not going to affect each other anymore, because one is the copy of another one. So what I do is I go into my user profile, I say copy, and I go in here and I paste my new profile in here. And I want to change the name to new profile, like this, and now I created a new user profile. It's a copy of the other one, so they're going to be identical in the beginning. Once again, just a small interruption here from our sponsor, which once again is Martin. And this time we're going to look a little bit about the P3 system and the Aura XIP. As you can see in the background, is P3 compatible. That means if you attach it to your network and you have P3 installed on a computer, you can actually remote control all your fixtures in your rig, regardless of what the console is telling it to do. So let me just show you how that works. You go into the Martin website, and I'm going to leave a link down in the description and up in the top somewhere. You can see the P3 PC system, which is free. You can download it and you can use it for your rig on a festival or something if you want to control the fixtures. So over here, this is how it looks when you installed it on your computer. And you can see the Aura XIP automatically just pops up in your system. It's automatically recognized and you can see everything that's going on. You can remote control it. For instance, you can highlight any fixture. You can see there's a lot of light coming out of it right now. And you can do all kinds of different things. For instance, if you have a rig that is set up in like the basic mode or ludicrous mode on your XIP, because you want to use all the multi-cell, and then suddenly you have a guest coming into your system and he says, oh, please, I just want it in the compact mode because I didn't program all the instances. You can simply go into your system here, select your fixture, and you can scroll down and find the DMX mode, and you can simply press it like this and you can change it. We're going to put it into basic mode, and if you look at what the fixture is doing right now, you can see it automatically changes mode, and you can do everything in here. All you can do on the control channel, you can do in here as well. You can change all the settings, you can give it new addresses, you can do everything. And that's the power of the P3 system with the P3 compatible devices. So thank you, Martin, once again for sponsoring this episode. And let's get back to the video. So now I need to attach the user profile to my user, which is going to happen in here. You can see our user here, and you can see right now the profile is the default profile, and I don't want that. I want to use another profile. The default profile is basically for your admin rights and your admin user and your 3D user and stuff like that. So I want to right click here and I want to select my new profile down here. And I should maybe have named it something different, because new profile, then you can create another one. So I just select this one, new profile, and now I've attached the copy of my profile to the new profile. And then we can simply exit this stuff here and we can log in as new. So we say log in, new, and we just say new here. And now you can see a change down here. So if I now look on the console, I don't know if you can see it, I'm logged in as Tue over here and I'm logged in as new over here. So right now, if I change my views, it's not going to happen. It's not going to affect the console over here. And this is what we want. This is how it works with the new users. The user is not only for working with your profile, working with your different layouts and stuff like that. There's a million things you can change for your user. So if we go back into our user settings here, we can see our users here and we can go into profiles. Under the profile, you can change a lot of the preferences you have as your user. And to be honest, I usually don't change a lot in here, but there's a lot of different things you can change, so everything is the way you want to look at it. One thing I do change, because I am probably the age I am, I'm used to programming with CMY. So if you go in here, you can see the color readout here is CMY. And if you look down here, you have CM and Y. And if you go in here, you can simply select RGB instead, and then it's going to use RGB for your user profile. It's still going to be different for my profile. We only changed it for the new profile. So again, you can do a lot of changes attached to your user inside of these settings over here. You have some different views with time code. Where do you want time codes to come in? How do you want the whoops to affect your programmer? How do you want the frame readout and all this stuff? So you can tailor it to the way you want to work with it. And that's pretty cool. And that is another thing about the user thing. There's no question about it. You need to play with it down here to find out what you need and what you prefer. I usually keep everything as standard as I can, because I think it's important that if somebody has to jump in my place, you have to figure out pretty easy how everything is set up, so the console is not doing all kinds of weird stuff. But that's just me and my preference. You can do it the way you want. So that's a little bit about users on GrandMA3. It's quite simple. You just have to go in and play with it and see whatever fits you and how it works for you. But if you are in a multi-console environment, sometimes we have three or four consoles on the same show. You have a guy doing video, maybe you have a guy doing conventional lights, you have a guy doing moving lights, sometimes you have a system on stage, a system engineer who needs to be able to go in and change stuff. This is the way you do it, and it is really, really simple, and it works really, really well. Then you can simply do stuff without interfering with each other, and that is what you want. So I hope you liked this video. I hope you're going to give it a like, and I hope to see you next time here on the Event Lighting channel for another GrandMA3 tutorial. Until then, happy GrandMA3 programming, and I see you next time. Bye-bye.